In this video, we are going to determine the angle an object has to be launched to have a maximum vertical displacement and a maximum horizontal displacement. So some of you may be wondering, what does it mean by optimal angle for vertical displacement? Well, what we're trying to do is find an angle that will maximize our vertical displacement or height. So let me write down over here. We're trying to find an angle that will maximize our vertical displacement. So looking at our diagram, we see that a cannonball is being launched with a velocity of v at an angle of theta. And we also see that the maximum height is this distance over here. So our objective is to find a formula that gives us a relationship between the projectile's launched angle and its maximum height. So in order to find the formula, we must use the second kinematic equation. You may have noticed I changed the acceleration variable to negative g. And the reason I did that is because it'll make our computations much easier. So like I said before, we must break up our velocity vector into its vertical and horizontal components. So we have our vertical vector and we have a horizontal vector. And since we're only focusing on finding an angle that will maximize our vertical displacement, we're only going to focus on the vertical component. So we know that the initial vertical velocity is equal to the original velocity times sine of theta. So let's plug that in into our second kinematic equation. So we have delta y equals our original velocity times sine of theta times our time minus 1/2 times the gravity times time squared. So this may look a little bit messy, but let's try to get rid of our time variables. So in our previous video, we rearranged our first kinematic equation to get that our time equals our final velocity minus our initial velocity, all divided by our acceleration. So let's try to plug in what we know. So we know that an object's maximum height has a velocity of 0 meters per second. And since we're trying to find the maximum vertical displacement, we can say that our final velocity is equal to 0 meters per second. We also know that our initial velocity is our original velocity times sine of theta. So we have 0 meters per second minus our initial velocity, which is our original velocity times sine of theta. And we divide all that by negative g, since we're replacing our acceleration with negative g. We can simplify this to our time equals our original velocity times sine of theta, all divided by g. So we have that our maximum vertical displacement equals our original velocity times sine of theta times our time, which is our original velocity times sine of theta divided by gravity. Minus 1/2 times our gravity times our time squared, which is our velocity times sine of theta divided by our gravity squared. And this simplifies to our maximum vertical displacement equals our original velocity squared times sine of theta squared, all divided by 2g. Now we have a formula that gives us a relationship between the angle a projectile was launched and the maximum height, and we get a formula that gives us a relationship between the time an object spends in the air and the angle a projectile was launched. Now let's look at an example. In this problem, we have three cannons that are launched with the same velocity but at three different angles. To prevent this video from being 20 minutes long, I went ahead and calculated the time and the maximum height the cannonball spends in the air. The pattern I want you guys to see is that as our angle increases, the time and the maximum height of our cannonball also increase. So even if you don't memorize these two formulas, the one thing I want you guys to take away from this video is that objects launched at a higher angle have a higher maximum height and greater times in the air. Now let's look at the optimal angle for our maximum horizontal displacement. Now we're going to try to find the optimal angle for our horizontal displacement. Or in other words, we're going to try to find an angle that maximizes our horizontal displacement. Before I do anything else, I forgot to mention that the time formula that we derived earlier only gives us a time from which the cannonball was launched until its maximum height. Now that we got that out of the way, let's try to find a formula that gives us a relationship between our horizontal displacement and our angle. In a previous video, we learned that the magnitude of our horizontal velocity is equal to the original velocity times cosine of theta. We also learned that our displacement is equal to our velocity times our time. And since we're only dealing with the horizontal displacement of our object, we can substitute the magnitude of our horizontal velocity into our velocity term. So we have that our horizontal displacement is equal to the magnitude of our horizontal velocity, which equals our original velocity times cosine of theta, so we'll plug that in instead, times our time. Since we're dealing with the horizontal displacement of a projectile, our time is going to equal the total flight time the cannonball has traveled. Or in other words, our total time is going to equal twice the amount of time it is to get to the top. So we can simplify this to our total time equals 2 times the original velocity times sine of theta, all divided by g. With this information, we can plug in our total time for t and get that our horizontal displacement is equal to 2 times our original velocity squared times sine of theta times cosine of theta, all divided by g. Now we have a formula that gives us a relationship between our horizontal displacement and our angle the projectile was launched. Now let's look at an example. So once again, we have three cannons that are launched with the same initial velocity, but at three different angles. To prevent this video from being super long, I went ahead and calculated our horizontal displacements. And you can see that the cannonball being launched at 45 degrees has the greater horizontal displacement. And assuming that our initial velocity stays the same, projectiles launched at this angle will experience a maximum horizontal displacement. And the reason for this is because if our initial velocity stays the same, our horizontal displacement is dependent on the product sine theta, cosine theta. And looking at the miniature unicircle I drew over here, the product sine theta, cosine theta is greatest when the angle is 45 degrees. So one thing I want you guys to take away is that if your initial velocity stays the same, projectiles launched closer to 45 degrees will experience a greater horizontal displacement. So in recap, assuming that the initial velocity of the projectile remains constant, projectiles launched at a higher angle will experience a greater time spent in the air and will have a higher maximum height. And projectiles launched closer to 45 degrees will experience a greater horizontal displacement. So the optimal angle to achieve this first goal would be 90 degrees. And the optimal angle to achieve this second goal would be 45 degrees. And in this diagram, I just redrew everything we learned today. Thank you for watching this video and hope to see you next time.